Hi, good morning everyone. Hope you all are fine at home. Enjoy your work. Today we will do second part of expansion of the binomial theorem. Yesterday we will do if you have two terms is given to you, how you expand if negative term is there and if two terms between positive sign is there, then how you expand it. Solve it. So you have to directly apply the formula of that is summation of r is equal to 0 to n ncr a n minus r and b r that you have to do. Okay, that you already did. Now we have used this formula, but what happened if there is instead of binomial, so there is a trinomial term like here 2 plus x plus x square raised to power 3. How you solve this type of question if I have trinomial is given? So in this case what we will do, I will just consider this constant term and this variable as a one variable, because trinomial of expansion in binomial theorem is not possible. First you have to convert this trinomial in the binomial form. If a perfect square is possible, you can convert it to perfect square. If it is not possible, so one company with the constant term, another with the variable, so you consider another variable. So here 2 plus x, so first we consider put 2 plus x is equal to y. So I consider 2 plus x is equal to y. So now this trinomial term now convert into the binomial form y plus x square raised to power 3. Now you have to solve according to your cube of the binomial term, and when you get the answer, replace y back into 2 plus x form. Now my next step is how to open this one, y plus x square is equal to 3 according to this formula. First is 3c0, first term is y, 3, and x square raised to power 0, that gives you 1. Then plus 371, then y, 3 minus 1, x square raised to power 1. According to the formula, we just replace the value of this here, and here y raised to power is 3 minus 1. Now next is 3c2, y 3 minus 2, then x square, so whatever power written is here r value, that becomes the second raised to power. Next, when r value and power value same, so that will be considered as my last term. Then y 3 minus 3 x square raised to power whole 3, because r value is here 3. Now when you open further this one here, so this is x square, this 0, so ultimately you get here 3c0, because we already find that 3c3 and 3c0 value is 1, so only y cube is left it here. 3c1, when you open this, that is 3, y raised to power 2 and x raised to power 2. Here you are not going to consider as this power as this power, because we consider as that is a whole power, because that is a part of my second term. X square is part of my second term. So don't confuse with this power. Only this whole power and second term power and first term power is equal to your binomial term whole power. So that is considered as y square x square. Next is considered as 3c2. 3 into 2 by 1 into 2, y, x, square and square, x, square and square. So that is 2 and 1, consider as 3, because this is part of the second term. This power is part of the second term. And your last is 3c3, 3c value is 1, y raised to power 0, x square cube. So that is left only x square cube, means x raised to power 6. Now my next step is I have to convert whatever y value is given to me. So I have to convert what I consider. First I will write in the proper way. This 2 is cancelled. Here y cube plus 3 वाई स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस थ्री वाई एक्स रेस टू पावर फोर प्लस एक्स रेस टू पावर सिक्स. नाउ दिस इज माय रिक्वायर्ड आंसर. नाउ नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज आई हैव टू कन्वर्ट बैक वाई इज इक्वल टू टू प्लस एक्स बिकॉज दैट इज अवर इमेजिनेशन. सो व्हाट यू विल डू, यू जस्ट राइट इन प्लेस ऑफ वाई लाइक टू प्लस एक्स होल क्यूब प्लस थ्री टू एक्स टू प्लस एक्स होल स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस थ्री टू प्लस एक्स. जस्ट इन प्लेस ऑफ वाई वॉट एवर वाई इज देयर यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट टू प्लस एक्स होल क्यूब प्लस थ्री टू प्लस एक्स होल स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस थ्री टाइम्स टू प्लस एक्स बिकॉज ओनली सिंगल वाई इज देयर एक्स रेस टू पावर फोर प्लस एक्स रेस टू पावर सिक्स. नाउ वॉट यू हैव टू डू, योर नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज यू जस्ट एक्सपैंड ऑल द टर्म्स लाइक 2 प्लस एक्स होल क्यूब फॉर्मूला 2 प्लस एक्स होल स्क्वायर फॉर्मूला ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर फॉर्मूला हेयर मल्टीप्लाई विद एक्स स्क्वायर देन 3 2 प्लस एक्स एक्स रेस टू पावर 4 मल्टीप्लाई विद दिस एंड एक्स रेस टू पावर 6 एज इट इज. देन आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन सो आफ्टर अप्लाइंग द फॉर्मूला बिकॉज आई हैव लेस स्पेस हेयर सो हेयर व्हेन यू अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला हेयर ए प्लस बी होल क्यूब दैट इज 2 क्यूब प्लस 3 4 into x that is 12x so that will be first 2 cube is 8 then next term is 12x because 3a square b 3 into 4x. Now next is your next after this next term is 3ab square that is 6 that will be 6x square 6x square then last term is x cube here third term is x cube. Now when you open this one like here 3x square first 3x square keep it outside so that give you a plus b whole square formula 4 plus x square plus 4x. Here also when you multiply 3x 4 into 2 plus x so that give you 6x 4 plus 3x 5 so that give you 6 x4 plus 3x5 and last is x raised to power 6. Then last is x raised to power 6. So now you just equate the like term, add it. So that will be your required answer. Now next type of question is in the binomial expression, if you have given two irrational terms like cube root of 3 and square root of 2 raised to power 5, find the term which does not contain irrational expression. So in this expansion, cube root of 3 plus root 2 raised to power 5, when you expand this, you have to find the position of the particular term when there is no cube root, either root is available in the term. So you have to identify that term. So only in that case, again, if you have the question like cube root of 3 plus square root of 2 raised to power 5. So what you will do, you just expand it again. So here when I go with expansion of this, again, according to the my binomial formula, so that is 5C0. So that is, now I'm going to write first term. Your first position is cube root of 3 raised to power 5 and here second term automatically raised to power 0 becomes 1. Next is 5c1 then cube root of 3 raised to power 5 minus 1 is 4. I'm directly writing the calculation and root 2 raised to power 1. 5c2 then again cube root of 3, 5 minus 2 raised to power 3 and root 2 raised to power 2 plus 5c3 cube root of 3 raised to power 2, 5 minus 3 gives me 2 and root 2 raised to power 3 then plus 5c4 cube root of 3 5 minus 4 give me 1 and root 2 raised to power 4 and my last term is 5 c5 root 2 raised to power 5. So first I will expand this. What is the formula in this according to my binomial term? Okay, now next what you will do, now you have to open this one. These are the binomial coefficient, and beside the operator, mathematical operator, this we will consider as our first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, and my sixth. So when you open, you can directly identify what will be the your term in which no root is available. So here when you open this one, 5c0 gives you 1, because here my rule is that if r value is 0 and in place of n there is exactly as power, so we write it here, as here. If you don't want to find the more calculation, so you can stop at that point where root is cancelled. So I can directly check from here, 5c0 gives me 1, because rule is that if r value is 0 and n value is exactly at your power, so this binomial coefficient will be equal to 1. So this is cube root, so only what is left, 3 raised to power 5 by 3, that will be written like that. Now next is 5c1, 5c1 give me 5, and this 3 raised to power give me 4 by 3, and 2 raised to power 1 by 2, that is a fractional power. Now next is 5c2, 5 into 4, 1 into 2. Here when you write like 3 raised to power 3 by 3, so that will be cancelled. Here also square root is cancelled, and 2. So I found that my third term, so there is no root is available. So you know, or you can say that power is not in a fraction in this case. Now what I will do, I check for other also if there any a further term is there. Next is 5c3. 5c3 means 5 into 4 into 3, 1 into 2 into 3. So 3 value is 2 by 3 and 2 value is 3 by 2 because square root is there. Then next is 5c4. 5c4 is exactly same as 5c1. I already told you 5 minus 4, if near about values there, you can subtract and reduce the value here. Like 5c4 give me again 5 value, then 3 cube root as it is, then 4 raised to power 4 by 2, so that gives me 2 raised to power 2, because that gives me 2 raised to power 2, because 4 divided by 2 gives me 2. Then 5c1 value is 1, and this gives me root 2 5. Ultimately you have to identify among this, there is, you have to find that term in which no fractional value as a power is available. This is first term, this is second term, this is third term, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Except this third term, all terms has fractional powers. So we ignore all terms and we just count the position of the term. So that is my position of the term is first term, second term, and third term. So we will find my third term is 5 into 4 by 2 into 3 into 2. Now you, when you cancel this one, so that gives you value 60. So that is the value of the third term. And your question was, in the binomial expansion of cube root of 3 plus root 2 raised to power 5, first you have to identify the term and calculate also the term which is available. Now next is where we can use, what is the benefit of binomial theorem in another questions also in the calculation. Suppose I have the question 10.1 raised to power 5. I want to find the value of 10.1 raised to power 5. So what I will do? So if I go with the calculator or like normal calculations, so that give me more calculations here. So better, first I will convert 10.1 into binomial term, and binomial term raised to power 5 I expand it. After the expression, I will apply the value and calculate. So here, if it is 10.1 raised to power 5, then how you will solve this one? So how you will solve this one? So here, 10.1, first you will write how you write 10.1 in the binomial term form. So when you write in the binomial term form, so you will write here 10 plus 0.1 raised to power 5, that is 10.1 raised to power 5. If you want to find the calculation of any value, you have to convert that into the binomial term, into that means into two parts, like 10 plus 0.1 raised to power 5. Then after that, according to your binomial rule, you have to apply the formula here directly, or you can first write a plus b raised to power 5 formula. After writing the formula, you can replace a value as 10 and b value is 0.1. But if I know the formula, I can directly apply the formula, and a and b value, I can directly replace my value. So here my first term start with 10c2. So I have two options. First, I will find the formula or apply the AB value, or I can directly write. So your first option is 5C0, as it is, where R value is 0 and 5. So that becomes, first term is 10, 10 raised to power 5, and second term power 0, that becomes 1. Now my second term, 5C1, 10 raised to power 4 into 0.1. That is exactly same. We just finished our a plus b raised to power 5 formula. So I'm going to directly apply the value here, 5c1, then 10 raised to power 4 into 0.1 plus 5c2. Now r value is 2. 10 raised to power 5 minus 2 is 3 into 0.1 raised to power 2. So whatever r value is here, you have to repeat it here. Then 5C3, 10 raised to power 2, 0.1 raised to power 3. So one by one, from the first term, one is reduced from the power and one is added in the second term power. Next is 5C4 into 10 into 0.1 raised to power 4. And my last term is 5C5, 0.1 raised to power 5. Your next step is, I have to calculate this one. So 5C0 and 5C1 value is 1. So only 10 raised to power 5 is left. That means 1 accompany with the 5 zeros. So I just open it. 5C1 value is 5 and 10 raised to power 4 and 0.1. When you open this one, 1 zero is cancelled with this. Only 5000 is left after calculation. Here 5C2 value, 5 into 4 by 1 into 2, because 2 is written. So starting from 5, I write 2 digit from the back of the 5. 5 is itself, and one more digit 4, and in the denominator you have to move up to 2, starting from 1, multiply the terms here. Now here 10 into 0.1 raised to power 2, 10 raised to power 3, 0.1 raised to power 2. So that means if you open this one, here 3 is there, here 1 upon, when you open this one, 0.1 multiply by 2 times. So that gives you 0.01. So that gives you 1000 multiply 0.01, or you can write directly 1 by 10 raised to power 2. So 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. So that gives you again 0.01. Next is your 5C5. This one, 5C3. 5C3 will be exactly same as, because 5 minus 3 gives you again 2. And whatever values here, same will be repeated it here. 5 into, or you can write 4 into 3. 1 into 2 into 3. So that gives you again same value. Now 10 square is 100, and that gives you, so I write it here, 100 into, and if raised to power 3 is there, then your value will be 0.001. then next value is 5C4, value is 5, because exactly same, and here 10 multiplied by 0.001, that is 5 into 10 multiplied by 0.00, because this is 0.1 raised to power 4 is there. So 0.0001, and here when 5 is there, you will write 1 at the 5th position after the decimal, like this. Now next step is you have to expand this one. 1 company with the 50, 5000. Then when you solve this one, 10, this is 1 company with the 40, and when 20 is cancelled, only 100 is left. In the next, here 3 is cancelled, 10, and 100,000, and again one denominator 1000 is there, so all term will be cancelled, 1 is there. Similarly, next term will be 0.005, then 0.0001. Last term. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth term. So after calculation, when you add this one, so that will be your required answer. Now next is, you have to find the value of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 plus root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6. And show that the value of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 lies between 197 and 198. First, what you will do, you have given root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 plus root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6. First, you have to apply the formula to calculate the value. Then you will replace the value. So this formula is look like that: a plus b raised to power 6 plus a minus b raised to power 6. So solving this type of question, I have two options. Either I can directly apply the rule. Rule is that if terms are same, one is positive, one is negative, if positive sign is between that, so that means you have to pick the odd position term, like 2 times odd places terms. Odd places terms. So that is equal to the same thing. If you don't want to use the formula odd places terms, so what will you? You expand separately this one. You expand separately this one. When you get the answer, you will get the same value. Because due to negative sign, even position value will be cancelled and only odd position term will be placed. So that will be 2 times, then 2 will be taken as common. So you have 2 options. Either you can expand separately, but generally what happens in your exam, we directly apply the rule. If you know the rule, you will directly apply the rule, like a plus b raised to power 6, a minus b raised to power 6, and 2 times odd places terms. But if you want to expand, you can expand like that: a plus b raised to power 6, 6 c 0, then a 6 b 0, 6 c 1, then a 5 and b 1, then 6 c 2, a 6 minus 2 is 4 and b square, 6 c 3, a 3 b 3 plus 6 c 2, a 4 b 2, b because b value will be increased. So here now c value, r value is 4, so this will be 2 a square and b raised to power 4, because a value will be decreased, a power decreased and b value will be increased. Now 6 c 5, a 6 minus 5 1 and b raised to power 5, 6 c 6, then a raised to power 0 and b raised to power 6, then plus between that. Now you open second one, so that is 6 c 0. Now here negative sign is there. Negative sign means, I already told you, instead of applying the formula, if negative sign is there, that means all your even position term, or when your r value is odd, your term will be in the negative form. So terms will be same, only here in the like even position terms or r value odd term, that will be considered as your negative. So this will be a6 minus 6c1 a5 b1 plus 6c2 a4 b square minus 6c3. Check out when r value is odd, so term will be in negative sign. This way you can remember. plus 6c4 a square b4, then minus 6c5, then a1 b5, then plus, because this is c6, because 6 is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 terms is there. So that means you have to go according to that. But when r value is, your r value is odd, that term will be considered as negative. When r value is even, so that will be considered as positive. 6c6 and b6. So that is your terms. If you check out that, this term will cancel with this one. So this term will be cancelled with this one, and this term will cancel with this one. If you check, so this is first position term, third position term, fifth position term, and seventh position term. First position term, third position term, fifth position term, and seventh position term. So only same condition is left, two times odd places of the terms. So what is left? 6c0 value is 1, a6 is left, then 6c2 a4 b square plus 6c4 a square b4 plus 6c6 and b6. Now you have to apply the value here, and I calculate side by side also in this. Like here, if I have this two times a raised to power 6. If I go with this in place of a, so we consider a is equal to root 2 and b is equal to 1. So wherever b is there, you replace 1, and wherever your a value is there, you have to replace with 2. So what you will get, 2 taken is outside, so that will be root 2 raised to power 6. When you solve 6c2, that is 6 into 5, 1 into 2, root 2 raised to power 4, and b value is 1. If 1 raised to power 2 is there, so 1 has any power, that will be remain as it is 1. Then 6c4 is value same as this, because when you write here in place of 6 minus 4, that gives you again 2. So this will be, either you can open 4 times or you can replace that one. 5 into 4 into 3, and 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. Again, your same thing is left. This will be cancelled and same will be left. Then root 2 whole square, and 1 raised to power 4 gives you 1. And last term is b6, that is 1. Because 6c6 is 1 and b value is 1, 1 raised to power 6 me again gives you 1. Now next part is, I have to calculate this one. So this will be 2 raised to power 3. So that gives me 15 into 4. So that will you calculate here. 2 taken is outside, root 2, 6 times when you multiply, that gives you 8. This gives me 60. Here root 2 into root 2, 2, and this is 15 into 2 gives me 30 plus 1. After calculation, when I calculate this one, so that gives me 2 into 8 plus 60 plus 30 plus 1. So that gives me 99. So 99 gives me 198. So that means my this value of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 plus root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6 is equal to 198. So that is my value. But now my next part of the question is, I have to find the value of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6. I want to find that values lies between 197 and 198. So now I go further from that. So I need to find only this value. So this term will be shifted on this side, like root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 is equal to 198 minus root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6. Now you check out the value of root 2. My root 2 value is generally what we consider in general formula, that is 1.414. So root 2 value is 1.414. So that is my root 2 value, 1.414. So that is a root value. So here when you subtract 1.41 and minus 1 for that, obviously, so there will be a value lies between 0 and 1. So that means this value lies between 0 and 1 only. it is not exact 1 or not exactly 0, but that lies between 0.1. So that means root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6. Either you add here because it will not goes to 1, okay, and but it will be not approaches to 0. So that means lies between that little bit, like if you subtract something little bit, 198. So this shows that this value lies between 197 and 198. So it is sure that root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 should not cross 198. And if you subtract the value 0 to 1 between that, so that means it will be lies between 197 and 198. Only that you have to show in this. Thank you. Have a nice day.